Hey Internet, it's RJ. Welcome back. Thanks for tuning into the show today. Now, today's episode, we have up to $500 up for grabs, compliments of U.S. Bank and their business banking side of the house. So, as we always do, we will cover this offer, the terms and conditions, requirements, and eligibility, basically everything you need to know to make U.S. Bank's $500 become your $500. So, of course, if that sounds interesting to you, then go ahead, press the subscribe button, and let's get to work. Now, quick housekeeping before we jump into it. Again, this is a business checking offer. So, again, personal and business are considered two separate things. Now, if you need help opening a business banking account, I have a full business banking 101 video that I will link down below for you, but I promise you this is going to be very easy. Now, I'll also link to the offer directly down below as well. It'll be the first pinned comment and the first link in the description. Not a referral link, simply get you where you need to go the fastest. Now, with that, again, U.S. Bank, they can be a little bit tricky, but this will effectively be a nationwide offer if you're willing to do some, you know, backdoor maneuvering that could make you some more money in the long term as well, so keep that in mind, but of course we'll cover that in our eligibility section. Now with the housekeeping done, let's take a look at the offer itself. And here you have it. We have, you know, this young lady here. She looks pretty thrilled because anytime you're handing out money, you have to have obligatory happy people. It's kind of a rule at this point. So easy manage your cash flow and customer payments with up to $500 bonus. So what, pray tell, do we need to do to get this $500? Well, again, this is going to be a two-part stackable deal here. So the first part, open new business checking account. There are three options. We will talk about those options in a second. The promo code is the same no matter which option you pick. I believe the promo code will auto-attach if you apply through the link below, but if not, just make sure that you have it copied, ready to go. Now, once the account is open, you will need to deposit $1,500 within 30 days of account opening. In addition to that, you will need to enroll in online banking, either through the site or through the app. You will also need 10 qualifying transactions. Now, there are other options here. I'm making it simple and say just do 10 debit card transactions of a buck a piece. We'll talk about in a second. So if you do those 1 through 4, that's going to net you $400. Now, in addition to that, there's another $100 if you accept and settle a U.S. Bank Payment Solutions merchant transaction within 60 days of account opening. That will get you an additional $100. This entire offer here is good through just about the end of October of this year. But again, they do run these all the time with varying amounts of money and promo codes. If you're watching in the future, just be aware of that. So there you have it. Those are our requirements. Now, again, there's three options for the account. We'll talk about them in a second. But really here, the thing to note is, number one, this is a business account. So there is no direct deposit, right? It's not a direct deposit from your employer or anything like that. They mean deposit $1,500 of new money. So basically take $1,500 from your Bank of America account and transfer it over to this new U.S. bank account. They also don't specify that the money has to stay there for any amount of time because, again, it's a checking account, so they probably mean for you to use it with that low of a requirement. Now, I wouldn't do it and then zero it out all the way. In all likelihood, I would probably simply leave the $1,500 over there until the bonus post, just out of safety. But again, they don't specify you have to leave it over there. Now, definitely don't zero out the account until the bonus post, but they don't say that you have to leave $1,500 on deposit. Now, the qualifying transactions, you do have options. I find debit card transactions to be the easiest to do. It's going to come with a debit card. What you're going to want to do is, and what I would do is, you know, 10 Amazon reloads of a buck a piece. That should be fine because, again, they don't specify how much you have to do on the debit card. Just 10 individual transactions, so you can knock those out with Amazon reloads. And yeah, there you go. And that's pretty much it. Of course, remember to enroll in online banking, which I'm pretty sure everyone was going to do anyways. But that'll net you $400. And for most people, $400 is probably the one to do here. Now, there's an additional $100 for merchant services, right? Because it's a business account. Now, I don't have the best experience going through U.S. Bank's merchant services sign-up process. I was trying to do a similar bonus last year and trying to go through merchant services, and the whole thing got messed up, and it never ended up working out, believe it or not. I'm not saying that's going to be your experience. I'd just rather be a straight shooter with you guys. But that merchant services required me to get, like, a point of sale machine and everything. I don't believe this one does. You'll basically have to go into your account, sign up for merchant services, and then process a payment like you normally would if you were a merchant selling something. It's not necessarily hard to do. It may be a lot of extra work to sign up for the account and then do all that for the extra $100. I kind of leave it up to you guys, but I think most people here will probably be fine with the $400 for a $1,500 deposit and 10 debit card transactions. I think that's actually plenty, but again, you have the option. So let me know down below especially if you have a better experience than I did going through merchant services. So with that though, now we know what we have to do. Let's talk about eligibility here, and we're going to stick on this point for a second. So eligibility, you have it on screen. First of all, can have had a business checking account in the last 24 months with U.S. Bank. You can have a personal one. Remember, personal and business, two separate things. Now, locations, you must have a U.S. Bank branch in your state or in be in footprint, basically. Now, why don't I list the states? Because it's always changing and people are always buying other banks. The last time I listed the states in the U.S. Bank, I think bought someone and expanded. So basically, if you have a U.S. Bank branch in your state, you're good to go. Now, if you do not, this is where the nationwide comes into play. There, you can be an existing customer. The easiest way to be an existing customer is through a credit card or a brokerage account. Now, I'll talk through this really quickly here. If you don't want a credit card, what I've done personally in the past, because I'm out of footprint in Michigan, there are no branches in Michigan, I've opened up a brokerage account, right? Open it up. It's free to open. You do want to close it by the end of the year because I do believe they'll charge you $50 at the end of the year for it. But open it up, wait a few days. Now you're an existing customer. Your information's in the system, and then you can apply for accounts, both personal and business. No problem there. The other way you could do this is to get a U.S. Bank credit card. And from my main channel, I have a full video on the U.S. Bank credit cards that I will also put down below for you. I personally have the U.S. Bank Cash Plus on the personal side. I have the Triple Cash on the business side. And you also might want to look at the U.S. Bank Altitude Go or even the Leverage card on the business side. You know, Leverage card's not necessarily a keeper, but it's got a good sign-up bonus. You can get like $750 back. So that's probably the way I would go, especially if you're going to play this game aggressively, because that's actually the way I did go. That's why I have U.S. Bank credit cards. That's why I got the Triple Cash, right? Because Triple Cash is a business card, hit a $500 sign-up bonus. It's no... doesn't count towards Chase 524 if you're into credit cards because it's a business card, things like that. So I got those cards, and then, of course, I got more of them because they're good, but that's besides the point. Once you have a U.S. Bank card, you will be an existing customer. So when you go to shut down this account, you know, in 2 more years when you want to do it again or do the personal one again, you'll already be in the system. So that is the route I recommend going, and plus it's going to help you stack even more, right? You're talking about $400 for the business account, and if you got the Triple Cash for $500 offer, $900 just like that from U.S. Bank. Pretty good. So I would do it. That's what I did. But with that, let's talk about fees and account closure here. And this is where we're going to get into our account options. So on screen, you have it, the fees and account closure. So I'm talking about the silver check, and there are 3 options here, but silver checking has no monthly fees. Now, of course, you must opt into e-statement. So you could do the gold, the platinum checking if you wanted to. Me personally, silver checking, that's the one I would do because of no monthly fees. Now, in addition to that, there are no early termination fees. So again, in my experience, you want to keep it open till the bonus post. And once that happens, I pull out all the money and shut it down. Again, if you've got a credit card or something, then you'll already be an existing customer and ready to go 2 years from now when this bonus comes back up again. But there you go. Pretty easy on that one. Again, if you pick the silver account. And so there you have it, guys. That is everything you need to know about this U.S. Bank business bonus. Now, of course, let's close out with our classic summary slide here to take this one home. And so here you have it again, U.S. Bank business side of the house, silver business check is the product you want, up to $500. Locations, either be in footprint or be an existing customer. We covered that, videos down below to help you out. Requirements here, deposit that $1,500 within 30 days, hit your 10 debit card transactions, the optional merchant services payment acceptance for an additional $100 if you want it. There are no fees, and then of course shut it down once your bonus pays. And so overall, as far as U.S. Bank goes, pretty good. This is one of their higher offers. So again, I would probably jump on this. I'm not eligible, or I would. I think the last time I attempted U.S. Bank was only been like last November, so it hasn't been two years yet for me. But other than that, I think this is a good one. Again, merchant services. Optional whether you do it or not, I still think $400 is worth it. But anyways, guys, that's going to do it for this one. So of course, you would liked it, drop me a thumbs up down below. If you found a particularly interesting course, consider subscribing to the channel. Again, posting content just like this every week on how to make banks' money become your money. Question for you guys is twofold. One, let me know how you backdoor into U.S. Bank if you have to, which credit card you have your eye on. Of course, if you're going for this, are you going to try for the merchant services play as well for the full $500? Love to get your thoughts on that. But anyways, guys, that's going to do it for this one. As always, thank you so much for watching. Talk to you very soon in the next one.